Could the teeth inside our mouths have evolved from scales outside the body? A Penn State University study says it's possible. The 2022 study, which was published in the Journal of Anatomy, is clear that it doesn't mean hominids, or ancient modern human relatives, had naturally occurring tooth body armor. Ancient relatives of modern-day saw sharks and sawfish, however, had something called rostral denticles, spiky menacing protuberances along their extended snouts.
It's creepy.
Penn State University researchers found that rostral denticles from the extinct Ichthyomyra sawfish were made up of stuff very similar to what modern shark and ray teeth are made from. Does this information prove the notion that teeth started out as an outside armor-like scale before migrating inside the mouth, as opposed to the outside-in theory that states teeth began in the mouth and moved outward to become scales and other body coverings? Not exactly, but it does show that in the late Cretaceous period, the jagged-edged stuff lining the outside of some sea animals' mouths was pretty similar to teeth. The Penn State study offers evidence that such an outside-in evolution is possible, as well as a potential explanation for the evolutionary development of teeth in all creatures, even us. Speaking with phys.org, Penn State Associate Professor of Biology and lead author of the Penn State study Todd Cook said it was once thought that rostral denticles had an external morphology and developmental pattern similar to scales. Otherwise, though, not much was known about how the tissues inside rostral denticles were organized, not to mention the hard outside layer called enameloid. Cook said, "Given that rostral denticles are likely specialized body scales, we hypothesize that the enameloid of rostral denticles would exhibit a similar structure to the enameloid of body scales, which have simple microcrystal organization. But after examining fossilized denticles with a modern electron microscope, researchers discovered that Ichthyomyra's enameloid was much more complex than that of body scales. Researchers found that the overall organization of the modern shark tooth enameloid was similar to the enameloid in the ancient sawfish. These findings provide direct evidence that the outside-in theory of teeth evolution is possible." Cook said, "Scales have the capacity to evolve a complex tooth-like enameloid outside of the mouth. It's possible that similar enameloid structures evolved on both the rostral denticles and shark teeth independently." But Cook said a more reasonable conclusion is that scales produced a similar bundled microstructure in teeth and rostral denticles. According to Cook, these structures likely evolved to help withstand physical forces involved in feeding.
Evolution?
Although the Penn State University study goes a long way toward proving the outside-in theory of tooth development in ancient sea creatures, and also possibly for modern humans, more study needs to be done, and more questions remain as to exactly how teeth developed in mammals. On the origin of teeth and the evolutionary advantage of biting, Uppsala University paleontologist Per Ahlberg told Scientific American, "If you're feeding, unless you're sucking in really small plankton-type stuff, there are definitely advantages to being able to grab hold of objects in the mouth." In contrast to the outside-in theory of tooth development, University of Chicago paleontologist Yara Haridi points out that ancient eel-like creatures appeared to have primitive teeth in their mouth, with no scales or denticles on the outside of their bodies. But that's now thought to have been an evolutionary dead end. And while the Penn State University study might explain the origins of teeth, mammals hold one other distinct evolutionary advantage over other creatures. We can not only bite, we can chew. This chewing gave early mammals a distinct evolutionary advantage, as their diets became more diverse, according to a 2017 study from the University of Chicago's Committee on Evolutionary Biology. Speaking with University of Chicago News, the study's sole author, David Grosnickel, explained, "If you have a very specialized diet, you're more likely to perish during a mass extinction because you're only eating one thing."